How's it going, everybody? Welcome back, and I hope everyone's having a good day. I'm having a pretty good day, and today, you know what? I'm actually out here with Bubba, and we're going to go see if we can find something good to tame. I'm tired of building. I'm tired of doing all that stuff at least for a little bit. There's a few things that I was messing around with back at the base, and I'll show you those later if we get around to it. Basically, just fences and stuff like that. Juice press that requires a bunch of sugar cane. In order to make the juice, and it's going to take me a while to make the sugar cane. So, if we get around to that in this episode, I'll show you. Hey, I made it, but yeah, I can't really do anything with it. But yeah, we're going down this little inlet. I've already taken out a Spino along the way. Just cruising down here, cooking me some food as I go. I have the campfires just in case I get any prime meat. And, yeah, it's working, you know, so we're going to get down here, see how far we can go in this inlet, and see if I can get anything. I'm looking primarily, hey, Parasaur, how you doing? I'm looking for Allosauruses, dire bears, stuff like that. These rocks are going to trip me up. I don't think I'm going to be able to go that far down there. Oh, hey, it's letting me go. All right, cool. All right, there's another Spino up there on the right. I see it. All right, let's just turn these things off for now. Oh, not that one. All right, that one and that one. All right, and let's get... Well, what level is this guy? Because right now, I'm just looking for a big, meaty dinosaur. One that will help me farm stuff. That's only level 12. So, that's not going to do. And I don't want... any... more herbivores. I've got a ton of herbivores, and they're just really hard to fight with. So, let's pull this guy over here. This button. Hey, Mr. Spino. I'm over here. How you doing? All right. But yeah, I'm looking for a dinosaur that's not going to... anything? All right. That's not going to harvest everything around me whenever I smack something with it. Nothing. All right. Come on. All right, there's a couple primes, so I can get that stuff cooking. Whole bunch of meat. All right, that'll work. Come on, Bubba. Let's get back on the boat. And this is basically just what we're doing. We're going down the river, seeing if we can find something, and cooking up any meat that we find. That and that. I don't need that right now. So let's go with that. Take that back. Take that back. Light that fire. And I'm trying to save all the prime meat I get because prime meat doesn't last very long. So I'm trying to cook it as soon as I get it. I mean, that makes sense, right? Right? Yeah. All right. Because cooked prime meat is better than no prime meat. I mean, in the long run. So, as long as I have a little bit, I should be fine, right? There's a raptor over there. And then, some salmon down below. I love the look of these new salmon that they put in the game not too long ago. They're so cool looking. Alright, so yeah, I'm going to be working my way down the river, and if I see something cool... Ooh, there's a... big Carno. Well, just a Carno. Let's see. Well... let's go like this. Take this meat, turn that off. Alright. And then take this meat, turn that off. Let's go see what level this Carno is. Alright, Bubba. Coming by ya. Oh, come on, Bubba. Alright. Oh, he's aggroed on me. What level are you? Level 100? Thank you. Alright, well, let's see if we can get this guy. If I can get a level 100 Carno, I'll take it. Can I get you inside? No, you're not gonna come inside. Hold on. Hold on, dude. Chill. Relax. Relax, man. Chill. Oh, another Carno. I'm on. Alright, Bubba. Alright, so we got that guy right over there. Okay, so let's see if we can get him in. Because he's level 100. I will take him. If that's all I can get. And he's taking off pretty fast. Oh, you're back. Get off me, Carno. All right, dude. You asked for it, man. Now, let's get over here. All right. Ah, I had to kill him. That sucks, though. All right. That sucks. That really sucks. Alright, so, yeah, I'm gonna be working my way down the river, and if I see anything, I'll bring you guys back, alright? See you then. Here, I found myself a T-Rex. I just hope I can get the sucker knocked out. Yeah, a T-Rex would do quite nicely. It's not the highest level, I think it's like 68 or 70 or something like that. But yeah, I mean, I'll take it. So, yeah. I mean, I'm not a big T-Rex fan because they're slow and they turn really slow. But, you know, I'm not going to look a gift horse in the mouth. So, yeah. And with the T-Rex, we get its health up. You can actually go just about anywhere you want. Oh, give me a smile. I see that Carno down there right next to it. And another one. This place is like Carno Alley. There's tons of Carnos here. No, no, no. Get stuck. Come on. All right. Come on. Give us a smile. Yeah. Come on. You're taking off, aren't you? Got her knocked out. Oh my gosh. This running mechanic on T-Rexes, it's insane. Alright, and it's in a really, really bad spot. If I end up finishing this tame, I'm gonna be surprised. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, look at this. I mean, she's way in the water. I got some prime meat on her. Her oxygen's not going down, which is a good thing. But I'm gonna need to get a little bit more prime meat. And, yeah. What level is she? She's level 68. Get plus 33 levels if she doesn't get hit. That's a big if. Yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna go see if I can kill these guys. That's actually kind of a bad idea, killing these guys, because they're so close together, they're gonna chain aggro. Let's get this Dillo out of the way. Alright. I don't want to just regular meat tame this thing, but I think I might have to. I mean, I have some cooked prime. But yeah, I really need to refine my taming technique for no flyer. So, yeah. Because chasing this thing all over, that's not an experience I want to repeat too often. Alright. You can go kill a couple snakes or something. Alright, Bubba, you have some cooked prime on you, so let me grab that cooked... Oh, I already grabbed the cooked prime. Okay, it's right there. Let's stick you on you. I'm gonna go see if I can kill me a couple snakes, because snakes give prime. And she's taming up pretty quick. So, alright, so I'm gonna go see if I can do that, and I will bring you guys back if she stands up or if she gets eaten. One of the two. Something's gonna happen. So I'll see you guys then. Say this. This place is pretty freaky. being in here, I've already pulled a couple leeches off Bubba, and oh man, I'll have to just keep guard. Every time I get off, it's like quickly hop off and then hop right back on, so where I don't get any leeches or any Mega Neuro on me. Titan bows are a big thing. So are these guys, Piranha. Piranha everywhere. Oh man, the swamp is dangerous. Alright. Wow. And all just because a T-Rex didn't want to sit still and get tranked in the face. Can you believe that? Alright. Alright, so yeah. She's about halfway. I keep sticking a whole bunch of, prime meat on her as much as I can. I'm really not even too concerned about it right in here. I mean, this is dangerous. All right, so yeah, I'll be back in just a little bit. All right, see you then. Looks like she's up, and we got 101 level. All right, hey, that's not bad. Oh, wow, I've been stressing it here. I'm not gonna lie, I've been stressing. All right, let's see. Can we get you to follow? Come on, girl. Oh yeah. I was going over to kill this guy for some prime meat. And obviously I didn't need it. But yeah, he decided he wanted to come back and hang out a little bit. So hey, we're gonna go like this to see if we can get this T-Rex unstuck. Come on. Oh yeah, there you go. I have no idea what I'm gonna name it. It's pretty color though. You're pretty, right? So yeah, let's see if we can get this thing back over to the raft. Oh man, I'm a ways away from the raft. I wonder if the raft is even still a thing. I mean, I had to leave that thing a while ago. All right, come on. Let's get this T-Rex over here. Don't get stuck on me. All right. Okay, so it's at high. Follow rank. All right, so you follow me a little bit. A little ways. Give me some breathing room. All right. Get over here. Tons of rocks. I have no idea how the T-Rex got over here, but, you know, I mean, it decided it wanted to flee from me for a long time and went running, and yeah. Come on. And over here by Carno Alley, whole ton of Carnos were over here, and I don't even know how I'm going to get this guy back. It's gonna be a trick to get it back. And the boat should be somewhere over that direction. Somewhere. If it's still alive. And there's no guarantee that it is. Yeah, guys, that's right. All you Brontos and Ankylos and stuff. The T-Rex that was terrorizing you? Oh, yeah. He's with me. Oh, yeah. Let's see, where is that boat? Oh, my boat was over there. Oh, there's my boat. It's way over there. I already passed it. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna get over to the boat, get this guy loaded up, and then I'm going to get him home. Hopefully get a saddle on him. And then, yeah, I have to go level him up a little bit, but oh my gosh. Never, ever, ever tame something in the swamp. Oh my gosh. The amount of stress that you build up by taming something in the swamp in this game, it's just insane. Oh, come on. Get him! Are you on passive now? Alright, fine. Alright, so I'm gonna get him back. Well, actually, you know, I'm gonna show you guys if I'm actually even gonna be able to get this guy back home. And I don't know if I'm gonna be able to. It's gonna be a trick. Yeah. And then I'm gonna take this guy out and see if I can get... another dino with it. Alright, so this guy's following Bubba. And there's raptors and boa over there. And there's the boa. Hey, Mr. Boa, how you doing? You just stay back there, dude. Alright. And then... yeah, he's coming. Alright, so I'm gonna get back to base. And I will see you guys in just a little bit, alright? See you then. Back up into base, and let's take a look at this. Alright, yeah. See, this gate, this fence, it's not that great. I mean, if you want to have, you know, like a picket fence and whatnot, I guess that's kind of cool. I mean, a picket fence, I mean, everyone likes a picket fence, alright? But yeah, it doesn't do much good to stop dinos. I mean, you can just run right over it with a trike. So, yeah, I'm not sure how good that is. Alright, so let's stop that. And I just had to ditch the boat. Yeah. And, let's see, T-Rex saddle. Let's get a saddle going. T-Rex saddle. Okay. What does it cost to craft that? You have to craft it, the smithy. Alright, so let's get over here. Saddles. Rex. Need hide. And fiber. I should have all that hide and fiber. Let's see. There's a bunch of hide. I have a ton of hide from this little adventure. Let's see. So now I still need more fiber. Alright, how much fiber do I have over here? 8. Not enough. How much do I have in here? Oh, there's 200. Hey. Alright. And then now I know I need to go out and try to find a bunch more fiber. So, saddles, Rex. Bam. All right. My gosh. Today's been an interesting day with the chase and the Rex and everything. At least I didn't have to use up any narcotics. That's the big plus. And also, I was having a hard time getting spoiled meat. So, I just went ahead and made up a trough, so where it could just spoil over time. Because usually, once you end up getting a trough, spoiled meat is not really a big deal. So, I have that. And, I think Bubba should have some stuff on her. Let me unload this really quick. Yeah, just a little bit. The thatch and the narco berries. Alright. Let's get this over here. The end of a long day. Man. Alright, so let's get that in there. And then where's that spoiled meat? Spoiled meat. Alright, narcotic. Only 19. Alright. Let's get this over here. In the trough so the dodos can eat their fresh meat. Oh, I have more narcotics. Or narco berries right there. Okay. And then, let's get this over there. I know you guys really want me to stick the saddle on the thing, but you know what? I have to put this crap away. I want to stick a saddle on that T-Rex. I mean, T-Rexes, they're not my favorite, but you know what? They'll do. Let's get this in here. Let's stick that in there. And that. Alright, and let's make 19 more of those. Alright. It was by T-Rex. Oh, my T-Rex is way over there. Oh, it's following me. Oh! Where's my T-Rex? It's like, dude, where's my car? All right. So, let's get that. Oh, hey, I have arrows and that. Hey, cool. All right, Cook Prime, I'm going to turn you into jerky. Oh, and here's the stats. I haven't leveled her up at all. She's probably got a couple levels on her. Let's see. Weight, 720. I needed a high-weight dinosaur, and why not a Rex, right? Right. 3,200 health, not good. All right, but we'll be getting that up higher. 966 stamina, not bad. Melee damage, 166. Again, that's going to be going up, too. Let's pump her up a couple times in that. And then let's stick a saddle on her. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. How you looking, girl? Oh, yeah. Let's see. Oh, a little bloody from when I leveled her up. Oh, yeah. Look at this. We have Rex. Oh. Yeah. This will do nicely. Let me see. Can I get that right? Yeah, that'll do all right. Okay, so yeah, and that's going to do it for this episode. Next episode, I'm probably going to take her over to the Crystal Mountain and get some crystal and see how that works. I'll probably do it on one of the rafts where I can just load it, just make it trip after trip after trip for the Crystal Mountain. I'll probably do a bunch of that off camera. Some of the stuff I won't, but yeah. And then I think I'm going to take her over to the Carnivore Island. That sounds like a lot of fun. All right. So, yeah, until tomorrow, it's Flinger Foo, and take it easy, everyone.